अस्सलाम वालेकुम कैंडिडेट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर नादिया कमल, गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट एंड ऑनलाइन टीचिंग मेंटोर। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन सिजेरियन एक्टॉपिक प्रेगनेंसी। सो व्हाट इज सिजेरियन एक्टॉपिक प्रेगनेंसी? अ पेशेंट हु इज़ हैविंग प्रीवियस सर्जिकल स्कार्स और सिजेरियन सेक्शंस, देन इफ द प्रेगनेंसी इज इम्प्लांटेड इन द प्रीवियस सिजेरियन स्कार, देन अल्टीमेटली शी इज़ गोइंग टू हैव द सिजेरियन एक्टॉपिक प्रेगनेंसी। It is a very rare form of rare presentation of pregnancy occurring in about 1 in 2000 and associated with increased morbidity and mortality. So as far as cesarean ectopic pregnancy is concerned, you see in this diagram that this patient is having a scar, and this scar ultimately is having this pregnancy inside the scar. So ultimately what happens that if this pregnancy is going to involve the myometrium and ultimately the perimetrium, and ultimately there can be rupture. So this can be rupture and there can be increased bleeding and ultimately the morbidity and mortality in the patient. So now as far as the diagrammatic presentation is concerned, you see here that this is the endometrium, the lining is endometrium. And in this endometrium, you see the pregnancy is growing on the interior in the uterine scar, and ultimately from the uterine scar, it is invading the myometrium and then encroaching the serosa. So this pregnancy ultimately can result in increased risk of rupture of the uterus and leading to hemorrhage and therefore increased mortality in the patient. Now, as far as the ultrasonographic picture is concerned, you see this is the endometrium. A streak lining is the endometrium, and in this endometrium this is the previous scar, and in this scar inside it there is the pregnancy growing, and this is basically the cesarean ectopic pregnancy. So you see here this is actually invading the myometrium, and almost full thickness myometrium is invaded. And this can even extend to the serosa, outermost layer, and ultimately can result in rupture. So this is basically an ultrasonographic picture of the cesarean ectopic pregnancy. And then if we go for the diagnostic criteria, then you see that in the patient with transvaginal ultrasonography, we will see empty uterus, and there is visualized endometrium. There is empty cervical canal. And similarly, we will see that the gestational sac is implanted in the lower anterior uterine segment in the presumed site of cesarean section scar. And what happens, as it is going to invade the myometrium, that is why there is thinning or absence of the myometrium between the gestational sac and the bladder. So it can even extend to the bladder. So similarly, you can see the flow Doppler at the previous cesarean scar. So these are the suspects of the cesarean ectopic pregnancy. And ultimately, how to manage this patient? This patient, definitely you have to see the patient in such a way that you have to consider that either patient is hemodynamically stable or she is unstable. Now, if she is stable, then you have to go for beta HCG levels. If these are less, these are not rising at 48 hours interval, and they show that the pregnancy is going to be failed, then in that way, the conservative management can be chosen. But you must know that conservative management is associated with increased morbidity, because if the pregnancy is expanding, ultimately it can lead to the risk of bleeding, the risk of rupture of the uterus. So expectant management is not chosen, so you can go for the methotrexate by intramuscular route so that pregnancy is not grown there. And if patient is hemodynamically unstable and she is having increased beta HCG levels, then in that case the surgical management is considered. Now, how to go for the surgical management? Either you have to go for the vaginal route, either you have to go for the simple evacuation and curettage, but you must consider that we cannot use a sharp curette. And other is that we can go for the hysteroscopic resection of the previous scar along with the gestational sac. And similarly, we can go for laparotomy with open scar resection. And or if we can also choose the laparoscopic technique in which we can go for the laparoscopic scar resection, and or we can go for laparotomy and the open scar resection. Now what we have to be vigilant is that the patient should not be actively bleeding, and we have to secure the hemostasis. And if all these are failed, then in that case we have to go for the total abdominal hysterectomy. So we have to take consent from the patient that there can be risk of rupture, there can be risk of heavy bleeding, there can be risk of damage to the surrounding viscera, like there can be damage to the ureter, there can be damage to the bladder. So depending upon the extent of this invasion of the cesarean ectopic pregnancy, we will choose the management plan. So this can either be the conservative management or it can be the surgical management. Usually the conservative management is chosen only in a patient who is hemodynamically stable. And if the patient is hemodynamically unstable, then immediately we have to change the plan and we have to move towards laparoscopic scar resection or laparotomy and open resection of the scar with hemostasis, or we have to go for the hysterectomy. So this was all about the cesarean ectopic pregnancy. And although it's a very rare form of ectopic pregnancy, but it is associated with increased morbidity and mortality to the patient. It was all about cesarean ectopic pregnancy. Thank you.